Welcome to Daily Newspaper Analysis presented by Narayana IAS Academy. Adultery is not a crime. Adultery is no longer a crime in India, though without a shadow of doubt can be used as a ground for divorce, the Supreme Court of India has declared. The law punished a man who has an affair with a woman without consent or connivance of her husband with 5 years of jail or fine or both. There was no punishment for women who were seen as a victim of the crime. The husband is not the master of the wife, said Supreme Court, thus unanimously sticking up for gender justice and calling out the Victorian Adultery Law, Section 497 of IPC, as arbitrary. The reasons given by Supreme Court. Adultery as a crime is advocate and would mean punishing unhappy people. Adultery is a result of unhappy marriage, but not the cause of it. Thirdly, adultery is a valid ground for seeking divorce. And lastly, the act is consensual in nature and hence cannot be a criminal offense. Argument against decriminalization of adultery. Adultery strikes at the very heart of institution of marriage and thereby the concept of family. Decriminalization of adultery will lead to moral decadence, which a country steeped in traditional values cannot allow. And lastly, all religions count adultery as a sin. Therefore, Supreme Court concluded that sexuality is a matter of adult individual choice and he or she bears the consequence of them. EC Code of Conduct. Election Commission of India's Model Code of Conduct is a set of guidelines issued by the Election Commission of India for conduct of political parties and candidates during elections, mainly with respect to speeches, polling day, polling booths, election manifestos, processions and general conduct. These set of norms have been evolved with consensus of political parties who have consented to abide by the principle embodied in the said code in letter and spirit. The Model Code of Conduct comes into force immediately on the announcement of the election schedule by Commission for the need of ensuring free and fair elections. In the landmark S.R. Bommai and others versus Union of India 1994 judgment, the caretaker government should merely carry on the day-to-day work and desist from taking any major policy decisions. The main points of the code are: the government body are not to participate in any recruitment process through the electoral process, during the electoral process. The contesting candidates and their campaigners must respect the home life of their rivals and should not disturb them by holding roadshows or demonstrations in front of their houses. The election campaign rallies and roadshows must not hinder the road traffic. The candidates are asked and refrained from distributing liquor to voters. The election code comes into force, hinders the government or the ruling party from launching new welfare programs like construction of roads, provision of drinking water facilities or any ribbon cutting ceremonies. The code instructs the public spaces like meeting grounds, helipads, government guest houses and bungalows should be equally shared among the contesting candidates. The public spaces should not be monopolized by a few candidates. On the polling day, all party candidates should cooperate with the poll duty officials as voting booth for an orderly voting process. There will be poll observers to whom any complaint can be reported or submitted. The ruling party should not use its seat of power for campaign purposes. The ruling party minister should not make any ad hoc appointment of officials which may influence the voters in favor of the party in power. Before using loudspeakers during their poll campaign, candidates and political parties must obtain permission or license from local authorities. The candidate should inform the police for conducting election rallies to enable police authorities to make required security arrangements. Since the S.R. Bommai judgment said that the caretaking government should merely carry on day-to-day work, Election Commission of India told them that Model Code of Conduct came into force in Telangana. Smart coaches in railways. The Indian Railways are set to launch their Make in India smart coaches with few features like black box and artificial intelligence powered CCTVs, matching international standards. These coaches are completely Make in India smart coaches with advanced features. The list of features are black box in train which records why an accident happened and whose fault it is, artificial intelligence powered CCTVs for catching crime, Internet of Things based system for wheel, coach and tracking monitor to find any fault in the wheel or in the rail to stop accidents, emergency talkback system, Wi-Fi hotspot information system, water level indicator technology and emergency intercom for passengers. And it also has entertainment using Wi-Fi based information and FM radio. India-Uzbekistan. India will provide all possible technical support from Indian side in the digital growth of Uzbekistan. In this line, two memorandum of understandings were signed. Firstly, the agreement between National Informatics Center India and e-Government System Development Center of Ministry of Development of Information Technology and Communication of Uzbekistan for strengthening e-governance cooperation, and secondly, declaration of intent between CEDAC India and Tashkent University of Information Technology Uzbekistan for cooperation in the area of capacity building in ICT sector. Thank you. See you tomorrow.